Hello everyone, this is Inter. Today's activities in Kerbal Space Program require a brief introduction. Now, if you don't want to sit around for the history lesson, you can jump ahead to the time I'm putting on screen right now to see more of this craft. But I thought I should start with telling about how this thing came about. It started with yesterday's video. Someone by the name of Andrew Boxhill posted a comment recommending that I go take a look at some of his videos, and in particular his helicopter ones. So I took a look at that, and then YouTube recommended I take a look at another new video that I'd never seen before. And then after watching that one, I got another YouTube link to go back to someone I'm already subscribed to, and I took a look at one of his helicopter videos. So I had helicopters on the mind today, but it was this video in particular, the coaxial, or technically a dual bearing, like inline dual bearing rotor. And I thought this was pretty cool, but unfortunately it was built in an old version of KSP last year, over a year ago actually, and it also required a mod that allowed infinite distance on the offset translation tools, so I wouldn't have been able to recreate it in stock anyway. But I still wanted to give the coaxial kind of thing a try, and it was Shadow Zone's small vehicle that gave me the idea for the size, and then it was Andrew's video about a different kind of capping of the structural cylinder to keep things more compact inside. And all those things together gave me the idea of going with a small electric helicopter using a flat end cap on the cylinders, and that would be able to have two inline, technically co-bearing but still sort of similar to coaxial rotor, and I could just have the blades themselves be adjacent to the cylinder shaft itself rather than at one end of the cylinder. So all of that together came up with this. And this is my first attempt at a quadcopter. People have asked me to do this in the past before, but I just never really felt up to the challenge. And today, yeah, I sat down to do a coaxial and ended up doing a quadcopter. Don't ask me how that happens. So basically, I actually tried making the coaxial first, and I got as far as one of these things, and then I saw how easy they were to make. I thought, well, hey, let me put that in a subassembly. So I did. And then I used the subassemblies to slap it onto this new craft. So here it is. I put three seats on it and goofy stuff. But without the seats, with all the command modules attached to it, it weighs just over 14 tons. And it can carry a payload pretty easily of an additional 4.5 tons. I can slap that thing on there and it'll fly away with that, no problem. I'll take this out and fly it. I just want to give you a quick view inside of the engines. I went pretty basic. This is just a prototype. I probably will end up going back and adding more SAS wheels inside here instead of the structural things, but that's for the future. For right now, it's really basic. I just want some structure inside. Got a couple of very basic ball bearings. But the key thing is, I took the wheels, I took the wings, and I attached the wings directly to this, can I highlight it? To this one right here, this structural octagonal girder thing. So I put it onto that, and then I just used the offset tool to slide them so that they are outside of the cylinder, and then I attached all the pieces. I do not have any generators anywhere on this craft, so it's entirely solar powered, which means we need to fly it at high noon, which won't be a problem. And then the last little thing I wanted to point out was this. This was actually a spur of the moment idea. This decoupler detaches everything in all directions, so by putting this little tiny octagonal cube on one side of it, it's going to give the ring something to push against, and the two of them will fly apart from each other. The reason I did that is because if I just had the ring on here alone, there's nothing for it to push against, it would fly straight up into the air and then come straight back down, and thanks to KSP physics, it would usually glitch through the steel plate and fall inside the engine housing, and I didn't want that. So, alright, let's go fly this. Okay, here we go. Let me take a moment and put all of my people in place. I got pilot, engineer, scientist, the whole crew. So I'll just get all these people into place and then we can start up the craft. Okay, we are ready to launch. So I'm going to detach everything at once. All of the pods will fall off and you can get to see these rings fly up into the air and explode. It's kind of nice. And those things exploding in the distance were the little cube struts. Okay, so currently we are in command of the central vehicle. It has a big SAS wheel out here with 30 torque, and it's got the 15 torques out on each corner. So I'm just going to activate that. Remember, we are strictly solar powered up here, all electric. And then I am going to go over to the rotors, each of the... Oh, that's the command pods. Go over to each of the rotors, get a good camera angle on those, and then we can start them up. Okay, so for this one, I'm doing the trim thing. I'm holding down Alt. I'm on a Windows machine, so I have a Windows keyboard. I'm holding down Alt and trimming out to one direction on the roll axis. And once it gets fully spun up, I'll just hit SAS to put on the brakes and have it go on standby, basically. And I'll do that with the rest of them. Now, because this is a quadcopter, I'm having opposite corners turn in the same directions so that both of their adjacent rotors are spinning in opposite directions. So you can see the two I just activated are spinning in a counterclockwise. If we look down on them, they're both spinning in a counterclockwise, but the neighbors will be spinning in clockwise directions. So that's how quadcopters work. They have deliberately conflicting rotations in all corners for better stability. One more to go. Oh great, now YouTube's gonna get me for Jeopardy. I hate YouTube. I hate a lot of things about YouTube, I should say. Okay, so here we are, we're back at this. I'm just gonna cycle back through the rotors and release... Oh, I should turn on the aerodynamic forces overlay so we can see the stuff happening as soon as possible. So I'm just going to go back through the engines once again and release all of their brakes, and we can see everything spin up. And there we go, lifting that payload no problem. The nice thing about this is it really wants to auto-level. It has no problem just going back to an upright position after a while. The one problem I really do have with this craft is landing it. I have not been able to land it so far, because you can imagine trying to go back through four engines in quick succession and reduce their throttle, or in this case reduce their trim, is virtually impossible. I've never been able to do it. It's just, I don't think it can be done safely. But fortunately, carrying this payload, this thing doesn't gain too much altitude, so maybe I can set it down gently again. We'll see. We'll see. Don't count on anything. Now, without the payload, this thing will actually do about 7 meters per second over the ground. I do not want to tip it down anymore. This is my first iteration of the craft, so maybe in a future version I will fix this. But right now, with the location of these long I-beams, the rear rotor's blade tips come very, very close to hitting it. And if I pitch this craft down any more than 10 degrees forward, any farther than 10 degrees, they will hit, and the blades on the back will break off, and the rotor or the quadcopter will fall out of the sky. So I have to keep my speed limited because of design flaws. But I imagine if I could fix those, it might do a little bit faster, maybe 10 meters per second or more. You have to consider it. It can't go too fast because of loss of precession and all that. We would lose the... Well, I guess it's sort of like vertical P factor, but anyway, we would lose the lift if the rotors were tilted too far forward. So it might go faster forward, but we'd start losing altitude. That's about as fast as we can go right now. Not quite 6 meters per second. Yeah, so, I mean, the nice thing is if I just let go of the keyboard, this thing will stay perfectly stable. It has no problems with that whatsoever. And it likes to level itself out. It's actually self-stabilizing. The only disappointment is you could easily watch a rover zooming underneath you, and that's kind of embarrassing to have a rover outpace an aircraft, but oh well. Alright, so this is probably really too high for me to try to do a landing, but let's see if I can One method is just to go through really quickly and shut off all of the engines, but I don't really like that method. So we'll give it a shot and see what happens. Let's see, you go to this one and boom, 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 boom. Ah, no, come back. Oh, bugger. Oh, no. Ah, that was bad. No. Oh god. No. Yeah. Okay, so yeah. Landing it, still an issue. But it does fly quite nicely. So there you go. Just wanted to do a quick demonstration of that. And I'll put this thing up for a download if you guys want to take a look at it. All right. Boing. See you next time.